Okay. All right, so we are live and we are ready, right, Marie? We can't hear you. Can't hear you.
Thank you, Genevieve. Hi, everyone. Welcome. I'm going to give a few instructions about interpretation in English, Portuguese, and Spanish, and we are ready to start our panel. Thank you for your patience with the technical issues. Olá a todas. Meu nome é Marie Ferreira. Soy comunicadora de comunicaciones de Afroresistencia. Darei algumas informações sobre a interpretação em inglês, português e espanhol. Olá a todos. Meu nome é Marie Ferreira, sou comunicadora de comunicação aqui na Afroresistance. Hoje a gente tem esse lindo painel sobre meninas negras nas Américas. Eu vou dar algumas informações sobre como usar a interpretação e aí a gente vai começar o nosso painel em breve. Eu vou falar inglês, português e espanhol, ok? Okay, so interpretation. If it's your first time using interpretation, the interpretation is available at the bottom of your screen. You can check a button called interpretation in the format of a globe. You can click there and activate the interpretation in English. And you can be able to hear the interpretation. This is if you're in your computer. If you're using your cell phone, it's kind of similar. There are like three dots at the bottom of your screen. You can click there, select language interpretation service, English, and done. Don't forget to mute also the original audio so you can hear what the interpreters are saying. With the interpretation, you are able to see all the speakers here, but you only listen to the interpretation. Okay, if you need any support with the interpretation, please reach out to me via chat. The chat is also available at the bottom of the screen. Okay, em português, como usar a interpretação? Se você está no seu computador, a interpretação está disponível na parte de baixo da sua tela. Tem um botão no formato de um globo que você pode clicar lá e ter acesso à interpretação. E aí você pode selecionar português. Se você está no seu celular, o processo é muito parecido. Tem três pontinhos na parte de baixo da sua tela, no canto direito. Você clica lá, nos três pontinhos, seleciona interpretação, ou se tiver em inglês, vai estar escrito Language Service ou Language Interpretation. Você silencia o áudio original, ou se tiver em inglês também, porque alguns aplicativos estão. Você seleciona Mute Original Audio. E não esquece de clicar no botão do topo que vai estar escrito ou Done, D-O-N-E, ou OK. E aí você vai ativar a interpretação. Das duas maneiras, você vai poder ouvir a interpretação pelo seu celular, pelo seu computador, mas você ainda vai ver as meninas, né, que vão estar falando inglês ou espanhol. And now in Spanish. Can we ask, please? Oh, um segundo, coisa mais. E se você precisar de algum tipo de ajuda relacionada à interpretação, pode me mandar mensagem no chat. O chat é um balãozinho também que está na parte de baixo da sua tela. É só escrever uma mensagem lá e eu vou estar fornecendo alguma ajuda relacionada à interpretação também.
Muchas gracias, Marie. Para la interpretación. Si está en una computadora, verifique la interpretación de la opción en la parte inferior de la pantalla y seleccione español, ¿no? Si necesita traducción a español. Entonces, solo escuchará la interpretación, no escuchará la sala principal, acuérdese de eso. Seleccione un botón con forma de globo. Ahora, si está usando su teléfono celular, seleccione la opción más o haga clic en los tres puntitos en la parte inferior de su foto y luego seleccione los servicios de interpretación. Silencie el audio original, seleccione español y ya listo. Solo escuchará la interpretación en español nuevamente. ¿Ok? Eso es básicamente para interpretación. Y vamos a ponerlas en el chat, vamos a poner las instrucciones por si acaso se perdió la cómo hacerlo. I get started immediately, no? Okay. So welcome everybody to our very first Black Girls 2020 panel, where we actually have Black girls that are participating. We have today we have girls from Brazil, Colombia, and United States. I just want to honor the space by, and you know, I'm going to hand it over in a second after I translate myself and Ana translates, while Ana's translating in Portuguese. This is an honor for us. Colombia y Brasil. This is an honor for us to have these powerful girls among us that are activated and ready for anything that comes their way. So please take a seat, enjoy. Just a reminder, we're not taking live questions just to honor the safety and the sacredness of the girls. Marie will put a link to the form. Marie will put a link to the form where you can ask questions and our moderator will access them. And yeah, so welcome. En español. Me gustaría dar la bienvenida a todos y todas y todes por participar hoy en nuestro primer panel de niñas 2020, centrando las experiencias de las niñas afrodescendientes y negras. Es un honor y un orgullo para Afroresistencia poder contar con estas magníficas niñas que hoy van a compartir mucho con nosotras y nosotres. Para nosotros es un honor y un orgullo. Voy a darle la palabra ahora a Itzel, que es nuestra moderadora y que yo personalmente he visto crecer a través de los años. Entonces es un honor para ella estar aquí. Y si no me, presenté, me llamo Jambiev Williams-Humphrey y soy la directora ejecutiva de Afroresistencia. También quiero compartir que el equipo de Afroresistencia estará traduciendo para nuestras niñas hoy. Y dándole todo el apoyo que necesitan. I just also wanted to share that actually the staff of Afroresistence, since we are actually going to be providing interpretation for our girls today. So we want to thank you, Itzel. I give you.
Wait, where's it?
I give you the word.
Aquí. Where's he?
Hi, everybody. Can you guys hear me? All right. Hi, everybody. I'm Itzel. I'm here today with Afroresistence, helping host the event for Black Girls 2020. Woo! So today, we're doing a multilingual conversation with Black girls from Brazil, Colombia, and the United States to celebrate the International Day of the Girl Child. For those of you who don't know, Afroresistence is a Black women-led organization with the mission of educating and organizing for human rights, democracy, and racial justice throughout the Americas. Let's give it up for Afroresistence. Woo! So today on our panel, we have Yoselin Quiñones, an 11-year-old Black girl living in Colombia. Yoselin loves to dance and is a social butterfly. She lives with her mom and her grandma, and she was a part of the Afroresistance delegation in 2019. I actually had the pleasure of meeting her and her mom and her grandma, and they're really wonderful people. She's a young advocate and a fighter for women's rights. Yoselin has been a part of Storytime for Afroresistance before, and she also held art programs via Zoom for Black children during the pandemic. Our next panel guest is Malea Felix Span. She's 10 years old and she's living in the Bronx. Maleya is a dancer and an entrepreneur who loves to travel and loves adventures with her family. Maleya has one sister and she has one brother and she also has two dogs. Thank you for being here, Maleya and Yoselin. Our last panel guest is Hilary Reverio. She's 14 years old and she's from Brazil. She studies in a public school and is also a social butterfly. She likes to talk about lots of issues and her favorite subject in school is Portuguese and she loves to read and write. Thank you girls for being here. Today, these girls and I will be having a conversation about their lives, their hopes, their dreams, and their challenges. So I would like to start off this portion by asking each of the girls to tell me a little bit about themselves and to introduce themselves to our guests. Go ahead, girls, whenever you're ready.
Hi, my name is Maleya Felix Fan. I am from the Bronx. I've lived here my whole life. And so a couple of things about myself are I love to dance, I love to cook, I love to paint and draw. And I love to take walks with my family outside in the park and play with my sister.
Hola, mi nombre es Yoselin Angulo Quiñones. Pues tengo 11 años. Me gusta mucho hacer deporte, sobre todo la gimnasia, porque es mi deporte favorito. A lo largo de mi vida, pues he vivido muchas cosas, experiencias buenas, experiencias malas. Pues acá en Colombia las cosas son como que en un balance entre cosas buenas, cosas malas. Y pues así vivo yo acá en Colombia. Muchísimas gracias.
Hilary?
Tenho 14 anos, eu sou do Brasil, eu sou uma pessoa fácil de fazer amizade, eu gosto de conversar, de ler e eu gosto de fazer amigos e eu gosto de sair, gosto de viajar. E de várias outras coisas.
All right, thank you, girls. You're all very interesting, and I'm glad you're here with me. So I'd like to start off our questions with a very simple one. So when do you feel the freest?
Eu me sinto livre quando eu saio com amigos, quando viajo. Ou até para a praia, ou até mesmo para a cidade, me dá uma sensação boa de descobertas e aventuras.
I feel the freest when I am outside with my family, having fun, playing with my dancing, playing with my family. Playing games, you know, going outside, playing in the park.
And you, Yoselin?
Pues yo me siento libre cuando estoy con mis amigas, cuando estoy con mi gata, cuando estoy en mi casa, porque pues estar con mis amigas es una experiencia muy buena, pues porque tengo con quien compartir, ellas pues me apoyan en lo bueno y en lo malo, y pues esas son las que hacen las verdaderas amistades. Y pues en mi casa me siento segura porque pues me siento segura, me siento a salvo, siento que es un lugar como para pues descansar, lugar donde puedo compartir más con mi familia y con mi mamá.
All right, girls. My next question would be, what does self-love mean to you?
Bom, potencial de tudo. Todo mundo tem que ter, pois, em minha opinião, a alma é muito importante. Se você se ama e se respeita assim como você é, é o que importa para você. É, amor próprio é você se amar do jeito que você é, se aceitar da forma que você é, sem ligar para as opiniões alheias.
Beautiful. Wonderful. You did great.
Self-love means to me. Self-love means to me is when you love yourself, you take care of yourself,
yeah,
respect yourself, mm-hmm. and do things that make you happy, that make you excited, you have fun at all times, and you take care of yourself.
Yeah. Also a good answer. Yosavin?
Pues, ¿qué significa el amor propio para mí? Pues el amor propio significa quererme tal y como soy, que no tengo que dejarme pues llevar por los comentarios malos, que no importa. Si te dicen, ay, como eres negra, no puedes ser mi amigo ni nada de eso. No, porque las barreras no son lo que digan las personas. Y el comentario más malo que puede haber en el mundo es el tuyo mismo, porque los comentarios malos no existen. Para las personas eso no significa que te digan como que, ay, no te juntes conmigo porque eres negra. No, tienes que seguir encontrando amigos porque no significa que tú seas una persona que no lleva en ese mundo. Tú eres una persona normal y corriente. No significa, no hay ninguna excusa de que tú eres de otro color de piel, no puedes ser mi amigo. No, tienes que seguir tienes que seguir luchando, porque no importa qué tanto te digan, tú siempre vas a ser tú.
Qué bueno. Good job. That was a good answer. All of those were really strong answers, girls. So then my next question is, why is sharing our own and our community's stories important to you?
Sharing stories about our communities are important to me because they tell us more about our community and what are in our communities, and to tell stories, and I like to hear stories about my ancestors and my families who lived before me. And I believe that is pretty awesome. So I like to hear a lot of different stories about my communities and my family.
Yosalin.
Pues para mí es importante contar nuestras historias porque pues para conocer más sobre esa persona, conocer más sobre para que la persona conozca más sobre ti y conocer más sobre ella. Y también es importante porque la persona quiere conocer más sobre ti y tú también quieres conocer sobre esa persona y tú no vas a lograr nada si no conoces su historia, no conoces sus gustos ni nada de eso. Tienes que conocerla más y por eso es importante para mí que cuenten nuestras historias.
Okay, and Hillary?
I think we lost her.
Uh-oh.
I think it's the internet.
Oh.
You can move to the next question. Okay. I'm gonna call her.
Oh, okay. So her internet was lost.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
What is your next question?
Okay. So girls, my next question for you is, what is your vision for the world?
Mi visión para el mundo es que nosotros vamos a cambiar de personalidades y no vamos a tratarnos como si fuéramos hermanos, que no importara si tú eres negro o eres indio, no importa si tú eres blanco, no puedes juntarte conmigo porque yo soy negra. No, tenemos que juntarnos así sea, no importa el color de piel, porque tú puedes tener los amigos que tú quieras, no importa tu color de piel. El color de piel no va a ser una barrera entre todas las amistades y todos los amigos que quieras conseguir, sino sobre que nosotros somos nuestras propias personas, y por eso yo digo que el mundo debería cambiar, en que debería ser más amable, no debería haber violencia, no debería haber racismo, porque eso no importa. El racismo para mí no existe. El racismo es solamente una palabra, no es nada más que una sola palabra, no es nada en este mundo.
Good job, Jocelyn. That was a really good answer. ¿Y Malaya?
Changes I would like to see in my community are how our people have been, how I believe that our people has been treated is unfair. So I believe that we should all be treated equally, and I think in the neighborhoods also is that we should have cleaner parks, cleaner streets, and places that we could just go and have trash and just things that are not supposed to be there.
Good answers, girls. So my next question is about yourself. So what is a dream that you hold for yourself and for your family?
A dream that I hold for myself and my family is I like to go out to the park every day. I mean, I like to take walks and go to the park and see the pond and see the ducks. And I wish we could share more stuff with each other and go on longer walks sometimes.
Yosalyn?
Para mi familia, un sueño es tener una casa grande y propia en la que nos sentamos seguras, en la que podamos compartir momentos hermosos, momentos difíciles en los que nos podamos apoyar, porque no importa, momentos difíciles, momentos amorosos. Y pues mi sueño es conocer a mis ídolos y tener una casa grande en la que vivir.
So Hillary, our question right now was, what is a dream that you hold for yourself and your family?
O meu sonho é ter ótimo futuro, ser financeiramente bem para poder ajudar as pessoas que precisam e países que têm baixa renda e ONGs que ajudam pessoas que também precisam e ajudar minha família também.
Very nice, girls. I think you're gonna achieve those dreams. You're gonna do it. I know you will.
What's your dream, Isha?
My dream? I would have to say mine correlates with Hillary's a lot. I would like to be financially stable. I would like to be able to provide aid to people around the world, help those people. I'd like to give power to people without voices. I'd like them to be heard and acknowledged. Yeah, that's the dream. Okay. So, girls, my next question for you is, what parts of your identities are you most empowered by?
Por la parte de mi cuerpo que me siento empoderada es con mi piel negra y con mi cabello, porque son los que más me ayudan, porque son los que con los que me siento fuerte, me siento una persona libre de las cosas que digan las personas, porque no importa lo que digan las personas sobre mi piel o mi cabello y mi piel siempre van a ser.
Beautifully put. Malaya, you want to go next?
Identities that I'm most empowered by are being a big sister to my little sister and being a little sister to my big brother. Also being a dancer. I love to paint. Entrepreneurs. And yeah.
Okay, so Mari just put in the chat before Hillary answers. Mari just put in the chat, the importation is not working as it should. Thank you for your patience, and they're working on it to make it work for everybody right now. So Hillary, what parts of your identities are you most empowered by?
na minha determinação. Porque eu sou muito determinada naquilo que eu quero e eu sinto o meu empoderamento desde aí.
Nice answers, girls. So my very last question for you is, what does it mean for you to be a young Black girl in your country?
En mi país, ser una joven negra es ser una persona empoderada, ser una de las muchas riquezas en las que hay en mi país, porque nosotros los negros somos los que ayudamos a Colombia a tener muchas, muchas raíces, tener mucho color, mucha vida, muchos bailes, muchas tradiciones, porque nosotros fuimos los que trajimos las tradiciones, los bailes, y todo lo que hace que Colombia sea una chimba y todo eso.
Good job, Jocelyn. That was a really good answer. Hillary, do you want to go next?
Pode ser. Ser uma jovem negra no Brasil, para mim, significa muito orgulho. Me espelho em grandes mulheres que fizeram parte da história do meu país. E também, ser negra para mim é simplesmente incrível e eu tenho muito orgulho da minha cor.
Emaleia?
Being a Black girl in my country is challenging right now because I'm seeing how Black people are being treated right now during these times. And I think that as my opportunity, I can show others how Black people do and, no, not do, but yeah, do and.
That's a good thing, girls. You have to be proud of your Blackness. It's a very good thing. I'm glad that you all said that.
Well, thank you.
me? Well, I'm also living in the US, so obviously I'm seeing how Black folks are being treated. But I also believe that because we're so resistant and strong and proud, we're gonna get through it and we'll be stronger from it. That's what I believe. I hope that this will bring unity to all people of color. And that's my hope for what's going on right now.
Do you have more questions?
I do. I wasn't sure if I should continue.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Maybe you can ask them if they want to share questions to each other.
So girls, I was wondering, did you have anything you wanted to ask each other since you're living in very different areas and different communities? Is there anything you want to know? You can go ahead and think about that for a second if you'd like.
Hilary, tem alguma pergunta que você gostaria de fazer para as outras meninas morando aqui nos Estados Unidos ou na Colômbia? Joseline, tienes alguma pergunta que gostaria de fazer para as companheiras?
So I actually have a question from somebody else. They would like to know about a time when you were. Oh, are you going to ask a question?
Você ia fazer uma pergunta? No.
Okay. So one of the questions that we were just asked, girls, can you share about a time when you were upset about something and adults thought they knew how to solve the problem for you and it turned out that they actually didn't know that what the problem was?
Pode repetir, por favor?
Can you repeat the question?
I can. So the question is, can you share about a time when you were upset about something and adults thought that they knew how to solve the problem for you, but it turned out that they actually didn't know how to relate to the problem?
Acho que isso é mais comum, né? Acho que isso é comum, porque nem sempre os adultos conseguem entender nossos problemas.
I definitely agree with that.
Tem muitas situações.
Malia or Yoseline, do you guys have anything to say to that?
No entiendo la pregunta porque es que el traductor lo tengo encendido, pero no se escucha la traducción.
Ishel, can you repeat the question in Spanish for her? Or tell me the question and I can tell her.
Okay, so the question was, can you share about a time when you were upset about something and adults thought that they knew how to solve the problem for you, but it turned out that they didn't actually know what the problem was? I'm assuming that the ending is they couldn't really relate to the problem, so they had no way to help.
Okay, Jean-Pierre?
Yes.
We can hear you, Jean-Pierre. Okay, the la pergunta, Jean-Pierre, I know that you were talking, but we can hear you. La pergunta es si recuerda una ocasión en que estaba confusa y los adultos pensaron que podrían resolver el problema, pero no podían. Estás muda, Jocelyn, estás muda. E o microfone está mudou.
No, no he estado en esa situación.
Michelle, we have a video of a question. Maybe we can show the video. Okay, Ishel?
Yes.
We are gonna, Malaya has an answer, okay.
Is this still the same question?
Yeah.
I'm gonna answer that. A time I appreciate when, if sometimes I can't figure out the question, but my parents do, they don't have the answer. Or they don't understand the question, so we still problem solve it together.
Okay, so we are going to show this video with a question from Evelyn, and then Ishel can, you know, move on and close the panel, okay? Let's see if you all can hear the video.
Hola, ¿cómo estamos? Me llamo Evelyn Álvarez y estoy con ustedes desde el Bronx en la ciudad de Nueva York. Mi familia es de Guatemala. ¡Woo! Y también quería empezar con deseándoles un feliz Día Internacional de las Niñas. ¡Woo, woo, woo, woo! estoy aquí, antes de empezar con mis preguntas, quería darles un poquito de información sobre quién soy. Soy madre, soy doula, soy hermana, soy compañera. También soy entrenadora, así es de que siempre estoy hablando con adultos. Y lo que más me gusta es hablar con adultos de qué es lo que ellos tienen que aprender y desaprender para poder mejorar las relaciones que tenemos con la juventud, con la gente joven. Yo quería empezar con las gracias a las niñas que van a estar viendo este video, porque en este clima donde todos los adultos están que revolviéndose completamente, la gente joven está ahí calmada, haciendo lo que tienen que hacer, ¿verdad? Nos están enseñando a nosotros cómo es que nos deberíamos de comportar. Y nosotros somos los adultos, ¿verdad? Y les quería darles gracias porque muchas veces los adultos en este clima, todo el mundo está con tanto miedo de que no nos damos el reconocimiento, no les damos el reconocimiento que merecen. Así de que antes de todo quería darle las gracias y quería decirle, si nadie te lo ha dicho hoy, te queremos mucho y te apreciamos antes de todo. Y también quería preguntarle a la gente joven, ¿qué es lo que a ustedes les gustaría decirnos, verdad? Si tuvieran que darnos un consejo a los adultos, ¿qué consejo nos darían? Así que tal vez un consejo de cómo es... Porque muchas veces la gente adulta no los hace igual, ¿verdad? O qué canciones van a ser las próximas en el hit. Y también díganos de todo, cualquier cosa. Yo quiero saber qué es lo que ustedes están pensando, porque yo sé de que juntos ustedes se juntan y después empiezan a reír de nosotros y lo merecemos. Y también las adultas.
Sí,
I'm going to
translate into English y voy también a traducir para portugués. ¿Me escuta? Michel, você me escuta? Okay. First in English. So she, Evelyn was saying first congratulations because she thinks that it's a really cute, fun, and important conversation with the girls. And she's really excited because sometimes the adults think that they know everything, but actually the children have a lot to teach them. So her question was, if you have a piece of advice to give to an adult, what would that be? O vídeo foi primeiro a Evelyn dando parabéns para todas as meninas do painel, porque ela estava falando que às vezes os adultos acham que eles sabem tudo, mas a verdade é que as crianças têm muito para ensinar aos adultos também. E, então ela queria parabenizar as meninas pelo painel e por essa conversa, que falou que é muito, muito importante. E a pergunta que ela queria fazer é: se vocês pudessem dar um conselho para um adulto, que conselho esse seria? É.
So I'm gonna go ahead and answer that question from my point of view. Advice I could give adults. I would say, I feel like sometimes adults have trouble remembering that they were also once children. When children make mistakes, are emotional in a way that adults maybe don't understand or don't like. I think that sometimes they forget that they were once children and they were once growing, learning as well. So I would say to the adults in my life, just remember, I'm still growing, I'm still learning, and I'm gonna get there, but I also need the time that you got. And I think that really the whole idea would just be like, lend support and understanding and compassion because they're still growing.
Some advice I would give to adults are to learn how to do natural hair for girls and for boys sometimes. Mommy, like, to learn how to do natural hair because it's sometimes hard to do natural hair for black boys and girls.
Pues mi consejo para los adultos es que se tranquilicen un poquito, porque a pesar de lo que está pasando, deberían de ser más tranquilos, no deberían de exagerar tanto, porque lo que está pasando sí es demasiado grave, pero hay que bajarle, no hay que preocuparse tanto, tanto, tanto. Por eso tampoco así todo eso, pero preocuparse así que ponerse la máscara esa que se protege los ojos, no solamente el tapabocas y ya.
O conselho que eu daria é eles compreender a gente mais, porque já estiveram a nossa idade. E sabem que, querendo ou não, temos desafios e passamos por muitas coisas. E é só ter mais compreensão.
All right, everybody. So my first thing is I would like to thank our panel members. You guys did amazing. You guys are amazing, strong, passionate, determined young women. And I'm so glad that we are the generation that's going to be fighting together. Before we leave, I would like to talk about one more special happening of the day. Today, Afro Resistance is also launching the Child Anthology, a multilingual collection of stories from Black children from 3 to 12 years old. And they're from across all the Americas and can be downloaded at Afro Resistance website. You should definitely go check it out. You can download it over there and take a look at the website. And that's it. I'll be passing it over to Genevieve. Genevieve, close up.
Okay, y'all. So I'm gonna do the closing because we can hear Genevieve for some reason. Genevieve, I'm just gonna mute and unmute you to check. Let's see now. Nah, gente continua sem te ouvir. We still. Okay, so there are people who can hear you. I can. Okay, can you hear? Maleia, can you hear Genevieve? Roseline, escuta Genevieve? Hillary, você escuta Genevieve? Okay. Okay, so since everyone can hear me, Genevieve, I'm gonna do the closing, okay? Okay, so thank you everyone for coming. As I said in the beginning, my name is Marie Ferreira. I am the communications coordinator Afro Resistance. For those who don't know, Afro Resistance is a Black women-led organization with the mission of educating and organizing for human rights, democracy and racial justice throughout the Americas, as Itel said, actually, at the beginning. And our work is focused on Black women and girls throughout the Americas. So today we have our first ever panel only with Black girls, and we thank you for attending. And please check out our children's anthology. There's this amazing collection of stories written by children, Black children from the Americas, a collection of about 10 or 15 stories in Portuguese, English, and Spanish. And you can download it via website. And to end, we want to say that we launched a couple of weeks ago our Black Latina Girls and Women Fund. That is a fund that gives money directly to Black women and girls in the region, like in the United States, Latin America and the Caribbean, who are experiencing severe financial needs, especially due to COVID-19. We just reached our first goal of $10,000, which means that we are finally, we are opening now the form for application. So tomorrow you can check, throughout the week, you can check our website to apply for the fund. There are funds for different categories and for Black women and girls across the region. So if you're a Black woman or a girl in the United States, Latin America, and the Caribbean, and you're experiencing financial needs and support, you can apply for the fund as well. And if you can, you can please also donate to support us to continue opening different rounds of application for the fund. I was just checking with the all the tech if Genevieve was back, but I'm gonna let her Genevieve, please speak because I know some people can't hear you. Author can't. Let's those who can hear you. Thank you.